You are only as good as your last shot. I say that over and over constantly, because when success starts to come my way, and it has recently, and we've picked up a lot of clients, we worked with over 100 entrepreneurs, bringing their stories to life in a book in 30 days. Like, it's unbelievable what has come our way. But I always think about that. You're only as good as your last shot. You see, I just picked up a pool table recently, and I'm getting back into playing pool, and my mind is thinking that way. So that's what this video is about. It's basically not about shooting, but position yourself in the next turn to be the winner, to be victorious, to set yourself up again for victory. Since we've had success, it's become a little easier to kind of fall into a trap of all we do is keep doing the same thing over and over and over and over. Well, that's good if you want to stay okay or decent at what you do. But in order to advance, you need to keep repositioning yourself. Case in point, since we've been helping entrepreneurs tell their story, we're seeing many trends about people. I mean, we are seeing how people do things, what they do to make them successful, different industries, whether it's spiritual, motivational, financial, it could be anything. Women empowerment, I mean, these are all different industries. A lot of the successful ones, after they have the book, what do they do next? And you can start to see how people interact after they're an author. Once they have the book, you're able to see what they're gonna do with it. Are they really courageous about their story? Are they gonna share it with everyone? Or are they gonna go and hide in the swamp and just wait for people to come to them? Because once you put yourself out there and you start to show the world who you really are, you know, criticism starts to find you. Oh, you should have done it this way. Why would you do this on the cover? Why would you do that in the book? Why can't you fix this one word? Instead of who, it should be whom. Just nonsense. Criticism that's gonna kill you on the inside. And it's not gonna yield any greater results for you. But the people who keep repositioning themselves, keep taking risks, and I think that's really what it comes down to. I'm seeing people who have become successful in a certain field, don't just stay there. They keep branching out, getting more eyeballs on them, getting to expand who they are, getting other people to know their personality through and through. So maybe if they met them over here, they might fall in love with them and say, I wanna do business with them over there. That's a key ingredient. And so what we're doing, not only just helping people write books, but now we want to start teaching about what makes people successful. What do these people do compared to other people? So we're going around to different colleges, different organizations, different, you know, speaking events, talking about success. And it's fascinating to see this, how this is developing. We're working with some incredible people. But now we've branched out from just books and entrepreneurs, but to be talking about success to corporations, to charities, to colleges, to students, whether they're in the business field or not, it doesn't matter. You start to see people like Ric Flair on wrestling. What is he doing that made him so big? You wouldn't believe it, but he's doing a lot of things that kind of make everyone successful. Matthew McConaughey, what made him successful? How did he get his break? Marilyn Monroe. I have a thing for Marilyn Monroe, and you'll find out about that, but what made her successful? There's a lot of pretty women. How can she stand out? What did she do? You learn all these things, and we're able to package it up in this thing called Zero to Hero. It's a seminar that helps entrepreneurs, helps business people, students understand what makes this most successful successful. And we're gonna have Anthony Lawley, stories, lessons from him, Nick Santanastasso, lessons from him, and you're gonna see a couple tidbits of what makes these people stand out. And we're gonna package in this comedy routine and really make it entertaining, make it like a movie experience. And you're gonna see some crazy stuff, but what it's doing, and I wanna put this, and I wanna document this, because you're gonna see this either now or later. Keep moving, keep trying new things, keep branching out, because you become stale in the public eye. You do not want to become stale. And I think that's why the big names stay on top. They have the resources, the connections, the ones, they can keep living an exciting, interesting life. So as you see, I come out here and I go running every day, clear my mind. Look how peaceful it is. Constantly by the computer, constantly doing things, and I kind of get stuck in this rut. And that's what happens to anybody, whether they're successful or not. People who go to this job 40 hours a week and they hate it, it becomes a rut. People who are successful at real estate and they stay there and they just do real estate, they become successful, but now they're in this grind, they can't branch out, and once they do, it becomes really difficult. The longer you wait, the less comfortable you are. Get up, let's try it, let's fail fast, fail inexpensively, and learn some things. You get to meet a lot of interesting people. I mean, I'm working with some top comedians now. John D. Domenico, Jim Meskimen. You're gonna see a lot of cool people we're working with, and it's all because we're branching out. Now, what is that doing? It's allowing us to interact with other big, successful people. Now, what's that going to do? It's going to branch off into other things. We're going to become like a multiple path company where we can start doing this, 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 and this. Now, obviously, we help entrepreneurs bring stories to life, and we're becoming really great at that number one entrepreneur book creation service, and we'll never let that go. But we got to keep developing ourselves, keep going in different fields, keep showing other people. We solve a problem with DreamStarters, but started from zero. The apparel line started from zero on demand, which basically you can interact with me one-on-one at any time, $50 a month, have any questions with me or my network. And then we have the events, which is Zero to Hero, talking about success. And then we have something really cool that's coming out here very soon, but it has to do with those entrepreneurs out there who have this awesome idea. They just need a little bit of money or resources. And so I'm pulling together some people, some individuals, some companies, some people who have some great resources, whether it's money or ability to solve a lot of problems. Anybody who has that startup or business idea looking for partners or people to invest in their company, we're putting that together, which is gonna be called the Started From Zero Investor Club or something like that. Constantly developing ourselves, constantly keep pushing ourselves in whole new lights. The more we do that, the stronger we become on in the inside. But we can get up and speak in front of everyone on any subject because we can always tie it back to these events, places we've been, people we've got to meet, and stories they shared with us and lessons they taught us. So going back to the lesson of playing pool, do not get stuck into just being the guy who just worries about the next shot. Position yourself for the next two or three or four shots. And I know there's only so much you can practice and so much you can plan for, but the longer you're in this game, you get to see that you really can plan some steps. Figure out where you're gonna go next. If this business does not work out, I'm going right over here. Now, don't go back to a job. Don't give up the dream, but be ready for another avenue. Okay, if this person doesn't pay me, who's gonna pay me to take care of this and who's gonna take care of that? What's my next plan? Am I gonna contact 5, 7, 10, 15 more people to try to get that new customer so I can keep this business alive? That's what I mean by having the backup shot. And the next thing is, okay, once I get this and I solidify this person as part of the team, or if I get this prop, or if I get this event, what am I gonna do with it? How am I gonna position myself in the marketplace then? Once I become a best-selling author, what do I do with that next? Once I get my verification on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, what do I do next? Once I get my Wikipedia page, what do I do next? These are all things that what's going on right now. Now, it's not just I just put all this in motion and then we'll figure it out. They have two or three or even four shots planned out ahead. And I think that's important. You guys gotta start doing as fast as possible. And the only way to do that and do it really well is to keep going right in the beginning. The only way to become a master at any of this is to try and fail and keep doing it as much as possible and shooting and practicing and practicing and practicing, going down to the basement and shooting and shooting and shooting, practicing. Plan for the next two or three or even four shots, you become really good at this game. So what's going on in my mind right now, you won't see for a little bit, but you'll see it and it's gonna be something else. Make sure you're doing the same thing with your company.